Hello everyone, this is Chinmay Dangre from Make Auto Clinic and welcome to our Autograph India channel. Today we are going to share some information on the EFM motorcycle idling. Generally a lot of customers come to my place and says that my idling is very high, but there are some problems. If the throttle body setting is wrong, then you might have wrong idling, understand? But if the vacuum pipe is broken, then you will have idling issue. The idling will get increased just in case if it is broken. Now what is vacuum pipe? Where it is connected? The vacuum pipe is basically given for the PAV system, pulse air valve system, or the EGR, what you call in cars, or the PAIR system. So the PAV has got a vacuum pipe. If the vacuum pipe is broken or cracked because of the quality or because of the usage or whatever the reason, then you will have high idling, which cannot be controlled by setting up manually in throttle body or through the software as well. So first of all, whenever the bike is giving you this kind of a issue, you have to understand which is the first point. So you have to check out first vacuum pipe. Now vacuum pipe, I'll show you. I hope you can see. This is because of the light. The vacuum pipe is basically this one. This is the vacuum pipe. This. The vacuum pipe is connected to the inlet manifold. And it is the second, another point. First point is connected to inlet manifold. Second point is connected to PAV system. This is PAV system. If the pipe is broken here, or if there is any crack, or if there is any leakage, then the vacuum will get leak. Because of that, the idling immediately increases. So this is the first problem. So it is not necessary that the throttle body is not set. So first you need to check whether the vacuum pipe is broken or not. I'll show you, I'll give the example as well. I'm going to start the vehicle. Remember, generally this happens in electronic fuel injection motorcycles, not necessary in car. But if the carburetor vehicles has got a PAV system, then this will also happen in carburetor vehicles. In Royal Enfield motorcycle, I mean in Royal Enfield products, the vacuum pipe is given only maximum into EFI and the standard 500, not in 350cc. So now I'm going to show you what actually happens when it is in broken condition. I'm going to deliberately remove the pipe to understand how does it work. Now this is a regular idle RPM. I'll show you just in case if the vacuum pipe is broken. This is the vacuum pipe. Now if I remove, automatically the RPM will get increased. This condition you can consider as though it is either broken or the pipe is missing. If I put the finger over here, the idling will come back to the normal state. Since in this motorcycle the pipe is not broken, that is the reason the idle is absolutely at a recommended RPM. I'll show you now how to change the RPM. Just in case if the pipe is not broken, as I told you before, first you have to check up whether the vacuum pipe is broken or not. Now the vacuum pipe is not broken, but still we have some RPM issue. That means there may be some problem with the idling screw. Now this is having perfect idling. Now I'm going to deliberately change the RPM and going to show you how to reset it. For that you might have to change the position of the throttle body. Now where is the throttle body? Throttle body is basically this component, this pair. This is throttle body. This is idle RPM screw, which is mechanical based, not electronic, right? This is butterfly.
this is MAP, map sensor, or manifold absolute pressure, right? I'm not going to work on this, I'm going to work on this. Now I'm going to change the RPM setter right now. I'm going to increase the setting. You might not have access to throttle body properly because the screw or the area is a little bit cozy. If I rotate this screw anti-clockwise, then it will increase the RPM. Now you can see or you can hear RPM is increased. This is the screw. I'll show you close view. This is the screw. Again, if I rotate it anti-clockwise, the RPM will get increased. If I rotate clockwise, the RPM will get decreased. This is the second setting what you have to check. First is vacuum or the broken vacuum pipe, and second is your idle setting screw, which is given on the throttle body. Now the RPM is increasing. High RPM. You might require longer screwdriver. I have already taken longer screwdriver. Sometimes you might require small screwdriver as well. Now the problem is what the idle screw is absolutely vertical. If you are not accessible because of the seat and fuel tank, you can rotate the throttle body little bit towards you by unscrewing or unclamping the hose clamp. If you make it loose and then you can rotate the throttle body. Since I am accessible to the throttle body, so I don't need to make it tilt towards my side. I'm going to show you RPM. Just plug the tachometer. Motorcycle, so the tachometer will never match. This catches the pulse, but this is valid for either single cylinder but single spark plug, twin cylinder, two spark plugs, regular, and four cylinder. But this vehicle is single cylinder, double spark plug. That is the reason that this is not matching up. So, approximately, I'm going to set the RPM. So, I'm not going to use this gadget. Completely fell. So I'm going to change the RPM approximately. Again, as I mentioned, you will be requiring longer screwdriver, and I'm going to change the idle setting. As I told you, anti-clockwise means it will increase the RPM.
and clockwise means it will decrease the RPM. So I'm going to decrease the RPM now. So approximately, this is near about 900,000 RPM. If the engine is warm, then you will get proper number. If the engine, if you try to tune this total body in cold condition, then you will get different or the wrong figure on the tachometer. This is right now almost 900 to 1000. After some more running, now since bike is inside, though it is hot, even after that also she might show us little bit higher number in RPM. This might go near to 1100 RPM. So these are two points which you have to think. At first place, don't directly try to connect your laptop if you are accessible to the laptop or to the ECU. Don't try to change any kind of a parameters in the software. First of all, check out the vacuum pipe, and second, if the vacuum pipe is broken, then change it, and then second, check the idle setting screw which is given on the throttle body. Thanks for watching. Stay connected.